When I was in graduate school, Elizabeth Murray, who's an artist, did a lot of work in the 70s in these large shaped canvases. And we were having a discussion, and she was talking about her thought process. And she said, when somebody comes into a gallery at one of my exhibitions and asks me, you have all these disparate things, what is going through your head? And she said, if you ask me right now, I can't recall a thing that was going through my head. But if you came up to me in the studio as I was developing these ideas, there's a very succinct stream of conscious dialogue that artists have internally and sometimes externally. And I was thinking about that in my own work, that when we're working or if I'm sitting by a stream doing these things, there's this kind of dialogue, like this goes to this, and then it's kind of like Bob Ross, and this is Mr. Happy Tree over here, and you're just doing like equations when you're doing this. But when you ask to recall all those tiny stream of conscious decisions that you're making in artwork afterward, like, I don't know, you know, it just happened. So I think there's a great honesty in artists that can say that they've relinquished that sense of control. A lot of times I tell my students to kind of make first, think about it later. So we use this gestural response to express ourselves and capture the moment. But it's kind of fun to look at a larger body of work after you've completed it and start to think about the links and ties. So for me specifically in this exhibition, it represents, you know, 6.5 years of work. There's distinctly different styles in the more expressive gestural responses on the polypropylene surface, which is a plastic surface that has a different type of reception to the materials, to the more tightly rendered pieces in the ink wash. And I think one thing that relates in my process is those gestural responses where I can capture the subject the way I want within a 2 or 3 hour period of time and never touch it again. Those are the moments I cherish. I think when you're working gesturally, the work is much more subconscious. And that's the allure for me of trying to be able to work in a gestural way and to achieve success. That's ultimately our goal as artists, is to kind of achieve that moment of kind of stillness where we're most comfortable. You know, that when we're creating, that's where everything else kind of disappears and that's where we belong.